Hi friends, so today we are going to discuss again from the ICAI study material, retirement of a partner, illustration 5. So I'm not ready to waste much of your time, so therefore already and I have drawn the lines for revaluation, partners, capital accounts, balance sheet, even bank account, and required small working notes also I completed here. I can explain. So because I want to save much of your time, I don't like to kill your time. I want to make it 100% useful and fruitful. Okay. So now though I know the importance of time at this particular point of time. So first I will read the question here and I will explain this. So and very important, even this problem 5 also and similar to 4th problem. Even here there is retirement come admission. One person is retiring. So, and another person is entering into the business. But let us discuss the goodwill in a different manner here. In the earlier problem, goodwill was adjusted through partners' capital accounts. So, and we worked out who is gaining and who is the same amount losing. The person who gained and his for him it is debited. The person who is sacrificing for him it is credited. In case of retirement come admission, that is known goodwill adjusted through partners' capital accounts. But we can discuss here the goodwill in a different style. The net impact will be same. Okay. Let us discuss that problem number 5. Dhaval and Company is a partnership firm having partners of ABC, sharing profits in the ratio of 10:6:4. 10:6:4 is nothing but 5:3:2. The balance sheet given like this: land, building, plant, machinery, furniture, investments, inventory, trade receivable. Capitals of ABC given: reserves, long-term debt, bank overdraft, trade payable. This is the balance sheet given. It was mutually agreed that B will retire from the partnership and D will be admitted as a new partner. So of course, out of ABC, B is retiring and D is admitting into the business. In the newly reconstituted firm, the partners will be A, C, D with effect from 1st April 2015. For this purpose, the following adjustments to be made. What are the adjustments given here? So goodwill firm, goodwill to be valued at 1 lakh, but the same should not be appeared in the books. See that how it can be handled. You may adjust through partners' capital accounts, or simply you can do one thing. Goodwill can be raised by the present existing partners in their old ratio, which means goodwill account debt are to A, B, C in their old ratio, which is 5:3:2. Okay. The same goodwill can be written off when the new partner is admitted, and it can be same goodwill can be written off by the new partners in the new ratio. So which means A, C, D account data to goodwill, goodwill to ABC old ratio, A, C, D account data to goodwill new ratio. That is a simple way to handle the goodwill in case of retirement come admission. Even if you work out through just like adjustment to partners capitals, like calculation of gaining, sacrificing and all that, and simply you may do like this. So goodwill rise to old partners in old ratio, goodwill to ABC 5:3:2, and the same goodwill can be written up by the all the new partners in new ratio, ACD to goodwill, that is of course in new ratio. Net impact will be same. So simple to work out goodwill in this particular method. Okay. So the net effect will be same. That is goodwill. Revaluation is done here. Buildings and plant machinery depreciated by 5% and 20%. Building 5% and machinery depreciated by 20%. For both, you may write the entry revaluation account at all to building as well as plant and machinery. Investments taken over by the retiring partner. So retiring partner, actually we settled a part of the amount to the retiring partner by giving investments, and remaining amount you may transfer to his loan account. But the important point is, while giving investments, it is given at 12,000. Actually in balance sheet it is given 12,000, but it is given to him at 15,000. So first you can increase 3,000 by the revaluation account, then it comes to 15,000. And that 15,000 investment can be given to the retiring partner. For that, retiring partner's capital account data to investments account. investments will not appear in the newly reconstituted balance sheet. Okay, that is what about the investments. Provision for bad debts also require 20%, which is anticipated loss. Revaluation account data to provision for bad debts. By the revaluation account, resulting profit loss must be shared by old partners in old ratio. We know that even retirement, death also same. And another very important point here. So in the newly reconstituted form, 2 lakhs capital should be there. ACD partners will be there. And they need to maintain the 2 lakhs in 2:2:1 ratio. 2 lakhs into 2:2:1 ratio means, I explained here. So total capital of the reconstituted form, old partners ABC 5:3:2 they are sharing. New partners ACD B out of ABC, and one of the partner B is retiring in place of B, and D is coming. New in the newly reconstituted form, the partners ACD, their new ratio is 2:2:1. And of course these people old ratio 5:3:2. Moreover, it is that total capital of the reconstituted form of ACD 2 lakhs, and it should be maintained like this 2:2:1, which means 80,000 for 80,000 as well as 40,000 to maintain these capitals like this. And of course, if any amount required, they can bring, or excess amount may be withdrawn. Adjustment of partners' capitals. Normally, you may do in this manner in retirement as well as death also. Adjustment of partners' capitals. And the surplus funds, if any, will be used to repay the bank OD, which means if these partners, they bring the money, so by the bank balance, and you can use to clear the bank overdraft 44,000, which is given in the balance sheet. And obviously, if you open a bank account, bank OD will have a negative balance, credit balance. If all the people, they bring the money, and bank OD will be converted as a favorable balance, and need not to say that it will happen definitely. And if they bring the money more than OD balance, let us check it also. For that, we may work out the bank account. The amount due to the retiring partner shall be transferred to his loan after giving the investments worth of 15,000. Of course, in book it is 12,000. Let us bring to 15,000 by the revaluation account. 3,000 profit we can recognize by the revaluation. And that investment may be given to the retiring partners. Very simple to work out here. Revaluation account required. Partners capital accounts required. Bank account required. Balance sheet is required. And after the retirement, come admission. Very simple to handle this problem. So just we can finish by 15 minutes. And I think that. Okay. Let us check it. First evaluation is buildings to be depreciated by 5%. Buildings given 2 lakhs, 5% means 10,000. Two buildings, 10,000. Two building, 10,000. And the second adjustment is given, plant machinery depreciated by 20%. So plant and machinery given 20%, in the sense 1,30,000 into 20%, 26,000. To plant and machinery. Depreciated by 26,000. Next, it is given that investments taken by the partner, retiring partner, at 15,000. It is 12,000 in the book. Increased by revaluation 3,000. By investments 3,000. And moreover, you need to make a provision for bad debts, anticipated loss 20% on the debtors. So the debtors given here, trade receivable 1,39,000. On 1,39,000, 20% means 27,800. Anticipated loss to provision for bad debts. On the trade receivable, you can make a provision 20%, which is 27,800, which is provision for bad debts. That's all. These are the only assets revalued like this. The resulting profit loss must be shared by old partners in old ratio. If you check it, it looks like a loss in the revaluation account. So debit total first 63,800. The result is 60,800. Right here, by partners capital accounts, only two old partners ABC, that is 5:3:2, that is their old ratio. If you share this amount like this, 30,400, 18,240, 12,160. Okay, this is the way to handle the revaluation account. And come back to the partners' capital accounts, particularly in the partners' capital accounts, you may work out. So, and you need to take the balance first. So, see what is the capital in the partners' capital accounts first. Balance 80, 20, of course, 30. By balance brought down 80, 20, and 30. 80, 20, 30, of course, that is the capital balance. Okay, for ABC, of course, D, he is supposed to bring the money. You may write by bank, but this is to be worked out as a balancing figure. You can't say right now how much he is supposed to bring, because they need to maintain the capitals 80, 80, 40. This is already decided. Two balance carry down for ACD, 80, 80, 40. 80, 80 and 40. So these are the capitals they need to maintain in the newly reconstituted form. To maintain the capitals like this, and how much amount they are supposed to bring, yes, they can bring it, right? That's why it is a balancing figure, how much amount to be brought in by D. Next, revaluation loss, you can debit that to revaluation account. 30,000 ABC, 30,400, 18,240, 12,160. So revaluation loss debited to all the partners in their profit sharing ratio. And next, if any reserve is there, you can distribute that to old partners in old ratio. 20,000 is there by reserve. 20,000, if you share in that way, 5:3:2, it would be 10,000, 6,000, and 4,000. And distribute the reserve to old partners in their old ratio. Reserve is over, revaluation is over. Next, the point is goodwill. And I said that here the firm goodwill is given 1 lakh. Goodwill you may adjust through partners' capital accounts, for which you need to work out and who is gaining and who is sacrificing. In that way, you have to adjust through partners' capital account, which we worked out in the previous class, earlier problem. But right now, let us solve in a different style. So, entire firm goodwill, let us raise to old partners in their old ratio. Goodwill to old partners' capital. So, in the old partners' capital by goodwill, so which is 1 lakh. We can raise in 5:3:2, 50,000, 30,000, 20,000, 20,000. So goodwill raised by firm goodwill raised by old partners in old ratio. The same can be written off by the ACD in new ratio. So ACD account debited to goodwill. No, it is not to be debited to only ACD in the new ratio 2:2:2. 1 lakh into 2:2:1 means 40, 40, 20. 40 A, C, and D. That's all. So simple to handle in case of retirement and admission. Raise the goodwill to old partners in old ratio. The same goodwill written up by the new partners in the new ratio. That's all. Even if you adjust through partners' capital accounts by working, sacrificing, gaining ratio, definitely the net impact will be same. Okay. So revaluation profit or loss given, reserve distributed, goodwill is also completed. That's all. Now let us see that, and the person who is retiring, and we can give the amount investments to be given, remaining amount to be transferred to his loan account. Who is that? B. Check it. B, credit total 56,000. 56,000. In fact, 18,240 revaluation loss debited, And I said that let us give the investments to him, two investments, 15,000. 15,000 given, and still whatever the balance is there, that is to be transferred to B's loan account. To B's loan account. Out of 56,000, if you minus these two amounts, and you may get the amount 22,760. And that should be transferred to his loan account. B's loan account, 22,760 transferred. Moreover, these people, they need to maintain the capitals like this, and for that, to maintain the capitals like that, how much amount and they are supposed to bring, and they can bring so by the bank balance. Definitely it is very clear, but first of all, the new partner to maintain the capital like this, and he should bring 60,000 rupees. Earlier there was a question mark by bank, now we can fill 60,000 rupees to be brought in by him. Let us check how A and C, both the people, B already settled, A and C, let us check it. So of course A, if you see debit total, 150,400. So if you check the credit total, 140,000. 140,000, and he is supposed to bring 10,400. And the another last person is C. This is 132,160. 132,160. And of course, check it. 132,160. Out of this, you can minus 30,000, and as well as 20,000, as well as 4,000. 132,160 minus 30,000 and 4,000 and 20,000. If you minus 54,000, and you will get the amount 78,160. He is supposed to bring 78,160. If you bring 78,160, and he can maintain the capital balance, of course, like this, okay, and 80,000. That's all. This is the way to work out the partner's capital account. Simply, we took the balance brought down first, revaluation loss, and how much amount D is supposed to bring, we can't say at this point of time. Reserve distributed, goodwill raised and written off. The retiring partner investment given, remaining amount transferred to loan. The partner's capitals, they need to maintain like this. To maintain the capitals like this, they have to bring the amount like this. Okay, that's all. And come back to the bank accounts. So when you come back to the bank account, once you complete your bank account, you may redraft your balance sheet also. Bank account, obviously there is no bank OD balance right in the credit side. By balance brought down because it is OD 44,000. You are having already OD balance 44,000. Because all the people, they brought the money, it can be converted as a favorable balance. A, C, D, all the people they brought. 2 A's capital, 2 C's capital, 2 D's capital, and all they brought 10,400, 78,160, 60,000. And if you check it, automatically it is converted like a favorable balance. And you check the debit total, 1,48,560. 1,48,560. So by balance carry down 1,04,560. 2 balance brought down 1,04,560. Yeah, now let us take the support of old balance sheet, and we can prepare new balance sheet also after the retirement of B and admission of D. Some assets and liabilities are not at all revalued, take them as is. If any assets are revalued, and you can consider that revaluation. Okay, right, first check the land. No increase, no decrease, take the same amount, 10,000 rupees land. Next one is a building. Earlier it is given 2 lakhs. There is a decrease by 10,000.
1,90,000.
Next one, plant and machinery. It is given 1,30,000. Minus 20% decrease, 26,000. The result is 1,04,000. Next, furniture. No increase, no decrease, same 43,000. Inventory. No increase, no decrease, take as it is 1,30,000. Inventory. Trade receivable 1,39,000. Minus PBD, provision for bad debts, 27,800. 1,11,200. 1,11,200. Bank OD converted as a favorable balance, so you can take here bank balance 1,04,560. You can check it. Investments is not taken there. Except investments, remaining all assets taken. Revalued assets at revalued figures. Other assets at the book values. Investments is not taken because that is given to the already retiring partner. Come to the balance sheet liability side, capital accounts. In this newly reconstituted form, only A, C, D and their capitals 80, 80, 40. And let us check the liabilities. And of course, still B's loan is there. B is not settled completely. B's loan is 22,760. And if you cross check, there are two liabilities. One is a long term debt 3 lakhs and another one is a bank OD is not at all right now. That is converted as a favorable balance. Trade payable 1,70,000. You can take them as it is at book values. There is no any change. Therefore, long term debt, it is given at 3 lakhs. Long term debt at 3 lakhs, trade payable at 1,70,000. Okay, that's all. There are no more items to write. Just go for the balance sheet total. 6,92,760. 6,92,760. That is the balance sheet total. And this is the simple way to handle the retirement cum admission of a partner. Very important point is the goodwill. In the earlier case, goodwill dealt as simply adjusted through partner's capital accounts. But for that, we need sacrificing and gaining ratio. But if you would like to do in this manner, you need to work out the calculation of sacrificing gaining ratio. It's not required. Simple to handle, rise the goodwill to old partners in old ratio, return off all the new partners' goodwill in new ratio. That is sufficient. Okay? Right? We can discuss the next problem. So, in the next class. Bye.